Good morning. Our opening hymn is number 667, Jesus in the Morning. Please stand.
A reading from the Song of Songs. The bride says, "On my bed at night, I sought him whom my heart loves. I sought him, but I did not find him. I will rise then and go about the city, in the streets and crossings I will seek him whom my heart loves. I sought him, but I did not find him. The watchmen came upon me as they made their rounds in the city. Have you seen him whom my heart loves? I had hardly left them when I found him whom my heart loves." The word of the Lord. Responsorial Psalm. My soul is thirsty for you, O Lord my God.
My
O God, you are my God, from my feet. For you my flesh pines and my soul thirsts, like the earth, parched, lifeless, and without water. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God. Thus have I gazed toward you in the sanctuary, to see your power and your glory. For your kindness is a greater good than life. My lips shall glorify you. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God. Thus will I bless you while I live, lifting up my hands. I will call upon your name, as with the riches of a banquet shall my soul be satisfied, and with exultant lips my mouth shall praise you. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God. You are my help, and in the shadow of your wings I shout for joy. My soul clings fast to you, your right hand upholds me.
Jesus loved and told them, they have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where they put him. Mary stayed outside the tomb weeping, and as she wept, she bent over into the tomb and saw two angels in while sitting there, one at the head and one at the feet, where the body of Jesus had been. And they said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" They said. She said to them, "They have taken my Lord, and I don't know where they laid him." When she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus there, but did not know it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom you are looking for?" She thought it was a gardener and said to him, "Sir, if you carried him away, tell me where you laid him, and I will take him." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Stop holding on to me, for I have not yet ascended to the Father. But go to my brothers and tell them, I am going to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord," and then reported what he told her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Traditionally, there is some kind of a difference between the way we do wink here in the United States and the way we do winks in the Philippines. When we do wink, usually we are with our dead at home and sometimes the way on beings from day one death until we bury our dead. It is about a week time for them to be at home simply because they are waiting for the relatives to come and be present for the funeral. But they will wait. We have a son, a wife's father who is outside of the country. They will stay and wait until this relative connected to the dead arrives. Now, why am I talking about this tradition? Jesus, in today's gospel, was put in that tomb, a huge hollow in a stone. You'll have to remember that one of those people who brought Jesus to the tomb was Mary Magdalene, the one that we're celebrating today. Exactly where that head and that feet lie inside the tomb, she knows. She knows. She probably even knows exactly the orientation of how things are inside the tomb. I think when you have somebody who is very dear to you, you exactly remember things connected to this person. We just simply don't. He's inside the tomb. Fine. No. What time? What was happening? What was the weather? And things like that stays here. We all have that strange experience of deaths in our own lives. Even here. I walked from the church to the cemetery when my dad died, and it was pouring rain, and I was walking behind the hearse to the cemetery, and when they took the body, the casket out of the hearse and put it exactly inside the place, the niche where he needed to rest, then the rain stop. The rain stopped. That was 1977. I wasn't a priest yet. Why all these strange experiences, and why do I talk about the human part of this all? Resurrection is not just a written document. Okay, Jesus resurrected. Here is your Bible. Read it. Believe it. Resurrection is a personal experience. The gospel today says, the Lord called and said, Mary. Mary turned around and said, teacher, my teacher. It's the reason why there is sometimes a difficulty of growth in faith among us. It's so difficult to grow in our faith because we want them to say, I believe Jesus rose from the dead, we celebrate that every year, period. A slow growth of faith. First, the gospel says, Jesus calls you. What's your name? Take away Mary. Jesus said to her or to him, then put your name in there. And you turned around and said to him in Hebrew, Rabboni. See the personal experience that talking about it. You cannot separate your personal experience and see the growth in your lives and say, I believe, I know what resurrection is all about. What did that happen to you? What did it bring you? What was the change that made that commitment to this risen Jesus? who is he? Not just, I know the Bible from beginning to end. What is your commitment to him? What did you do? Tell me, then I will tell you what this gospel is all about. What did you do for him? The gospel said, after this, she went to the other disciples and said, the person that I know, my teacher, he appeared to me. My teacher. It's the reason why sometimes in our dreams, when we remember and have dreams of our dead relatives, immediately, it's not just saying, I dream of my dad, or I dream of my mother, I dream of this dead person. No. Immediately, the thing that we will do is to share and tell others. I dreamt of this loved one. Do you truly love Jesus? Did he call your name? What was your response? And until now, you grow in faith. What have you done? In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Let us all stand up for our prayers. We trust in the power of the risen Christ. Let us boldly offer God our prayers and our needs this day. For the Church, may the Holy Spirit fortify her in supporting the dignity and flourishing of all human life. For leaders in governments and society, may they be given the grace to learn from the wisdom of others. Let us pray to the Lord. For all who grieve, may they be given hope in the living Christ. Let us pray to the Lord. And for the intentions of this Mass, for Jennifer Manalo, for the protection of all who are vulnerable, especially those who have special needs, we pray to them. God and gracious God, please hear these prayers we offer you through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, with your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, for the earth and the way to give and hence to become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, for the divine and work of human hands to become our spiritual bread. Pray, my dear friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, the offerings presented in commemoration of Saint Mary Magdalene, whose homage of charity and grace be accepted by your only begotten Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Keep up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for in the marvelous confession of your saints, you make your church fruitful with strength ever new. And
offer us sure signs of your love, and that your saving mysteries may be fulfilled. With great example, let us cherish the fervent prayers, sustain us in all we do. So, Lord, with all angels and saints, we give you thanks, as in exaltation we claim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth, glory, glory, Hosanna in the highest, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the Father of holiness, may you be there for you. By sending down your Spirit upon them like the newborn, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." Similar way, when supper was entered into the chalice and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat his bread and drink his cup, proclaim your death until you come. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray, partaking the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Blaise, our Bishop, with all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. And all who have died in your mercy, welcome them to the light of your face and mercy on us all, we pray. That we, the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Apostles, and the Saints, who have preached throughout the ages, we may marry and be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
Savior's command and form by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
O our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy come, and thy word be done, since it happened.
Give us this day our daily bread, give us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, to be await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grace we grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. We live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord with you all.
Amen.
Let us offer each other this sign. Lamb of God,
take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Jesus the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you are married, but also is worthy of my soul to all be healed.
Our communion song is number 480. This is my Lord, my God, my home.
Let us pray. May the Holy reception of your mysteries, Lord, instill in us that preserving love, persevering love, which means and which Saint Mary Magdalene have experienced, God bless goodly to Christ our Master, our teacher, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Almighty God bless us all. Father, the Son, and the Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass has been offered. Go and share the blessings you have received.
Thanks be to God.
Our recessional songs, number 537, Sing and Your Song.
Thank you.